Intel is a company which makes processors for computers for a very long time. The last releases from Intel were Core I series, which were released in 2008. And every year, its next generation is just came up. But this year, Intel has released its X series processors along with a new processor called Intel Core i9. I'm Sneh Ahmed, and you are watching the Tech in Depth series episode 8. Stay tuned. So back to our point, Intel made i-series processors over 7 years with the name of i3, i5 and i7 processors. These processors gave a user enough power to do from day-to-day tasks to business work and also high-level working like software development, virtualization, graphics designing and much more. Moreover, Intel continued to improve the performance over time with new generations of i-series processors every year. And now 7 generations have passed. Now Intel took a step to make a better processor than i7, even more powerful, the brand new Intel Core i9. The Intel Core i9 is not a small processor. Its base model contains 10 cores clocked at the rate of 3.3 GHz. This processor also supports LGA 2066 sockets and better support for DDR4 memory. That's all nice, but our question of the day is, does it really make sense? Well, maybe and maybe not. It makes sense because software becomes heavy and advanced every year, and it becomes difficult for the hardware to support those new compatible softwares. Not only to run them, but also smoothly ram them on the PCs. Also, AMD has recently released their new processor, which claimed to be more powerful and also perform more powerful than i7 processor. So in order to compete and save the market, Intel had to make a new processor. At the same time, it also doesn't make sense, because Core i3, i5 and i7 were enough for the consumers. These three processors were targeted for a consumer market, not for server markets. Core i3 was designed for light working on day-to-day tasks, Core i5 for more powerful and professional tasks in business and offices, and Core i7 for very powerful PC experience at home or at work. For servers, Intel got a Xeon processor family, which already offers up to 22-core CPU, while those CPUs were max of quad-core. So it doesn't fit for a regular consumer right now, because i7 was enough for the consumer. But like I said, technology is evolving, so this processor might be needed in this case. i3 is becoming less powerful with time, and Intel has decided to drop i3 to continue their new X series with i5, i7 and i9. So it makes sense in this way too. Core i9 will be a good option for a person who wants a lot of PC power. It also costs $199 only for the processor unit. But we can say that it's not a bad move. Technology continues to evolve, processors should also evolve. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like such videos, then please subscribe to the channel. I upload such videos in the Tech in Depth series weekly. And follow us on social media. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you in the next video.